Suddenly, water came to our house. Then some waves again came. Then our house was ruined with the big waves. Another waves came again. Then my elder brother told us, Ma, I think we're already having to die.
On the 8th of November 2013, Typhoon Haiyan swept through the Philippines, leaving a trail of destruction in its wake.
These people have lost everything, and they need everything, and they need it very quickly.
I'm very, very afraid because my baby is not safe because of typhoon.
Hospitals are destroyed, doctors are gone, medicine is washed away.
So this is our original house.
Within 24 hours, MSF's emergency response was underway.
Now we have already a medical team on the spot, and we will increase those teams at least to 50 people, including surgeons, anesthetists, nurses.
On arrival in the Philippines, MSF's teams were met with a level of devastation rarely seen.
When we came here, we found a totally flattened town. The houses all are down, the hospital totally in ruins.
Tacloban City on Leyte Island was one of the hardest hit areas, with roads blocked by debris. Reaching people in need was challenging.
It took 6 days for the team to get to Tacloban. They met with massive destruction of homes and infrastructure and impassable roads.
Tacloban's one remaining hospital was severely damaged, so MSF set up an inflatable hospital in its parking lot. The inflatable hospital, which has 45 beds, an operating theatre and a neonatal unit, is one of only two referral hospitals providing emergency treatment and surgery in the area. MSF also repaired the worst of the damage to the hospital's operating theatre. At 3 a.m. on the 27th of November, baby Romy became the first newborn under MSF's care in Tacloban. Meanwhile, many rural communities remain completely cut off from help.
Tantafi is one of the most sort of struck towns in the area, but it was neglected so far, and we have to suspect that many places like this still exist in the Philippines. I'm quite shocked to see that we are the first medical team to be here to help them. Certainly there are medical needs. I mean, within half a day, such a high number of patients to treat.
Some remote parts of Panay Island and the surrounding archipelago were only accessible by helicopter. MSF's teams provided support to local health centres, setting up mobile clinics across the islands.
All the infrastructure were totally or partially destroyed. We estimate that there's about 40,000 people living on those islands. They have all lost everything.
Everybody needs food and water there in this island because we're lack of water and food.
In Buraran, on Samar Island, MSF teams set up a tented hospital in the grounds of the city's damaged hospital, with an operating theatre for carrying out minor surgery and emergency caesareans.
The idea for our team of MSF at the moment is to support this hospital as well as all the municipalities depending on this district hospital as a referral centre, to be able to provide medical care to victims of the typhoon, but also to continue medical care.
As well as healthcare, MSF teams have been distributing essential relief items to families living in isolated communities.
The situation of the area today is still quite devastated. We have a lot of waste. There is a strong difficulty to access to good water. All these things can bring an increase on disease. So what we are doing is a distribution. We are giving plastic seating or tents. We are giving hygiene kits to ensure that they have the minimum.
The damage caused by Typhoon Haiyan was not just physical, and MSF teams were quick to set up a mental health program for those suffering psychological distress.
We might feel a little bit afraid, or we might feel that we are weak when we are experiencing those things. And that is in those moments that it's good to talk to someone about how we feel and how we can make things to feel better.
Well, I just saw a mother with her very small child, and she started crying, and for me, it was a clear signal how traumatized they are. And if you ask them, how are you, then they can release the pain, the mental stress they had.
Reaching out by boat, helicopter, plane and road, MSF emergency teams have provided much-needed aid to some of the hardest-hit areas of the Philippines. Although the relief effort is well underway, MSF will continue to work in the Philippines for as long as they are needed.